Like yesterday, I remember the night. Saw you driving by. You had a bitch in the passenger side. I called your phone, and then you denied me. That really surprised me. That wasn't like you. I thought you liked me. But now I just don't know. Where did all your feelings go? I thought we were taking it slow, and I thought you was waiting on me. But just like that, you turned your back. And you act like everything I did for you, you just take it back.
That was deep. That
was deep. Did you feel? Was that good? Was that good? Didn't even let me finish, but thank you. That was, again, another original piece, y'all.
Okay.
Y'all know I write all these poems myself. Thank you.
All right, now. Okay. Wrap it up.
Anyways. Welcome back to the Too Familiar podcast. I am Marlene Ariel.
And I'm your girl, Tish B.
Period. And we're back.
Yes.
We're in a new setup.
Yeah. As y'all can see.
We down here in Dallas. I just got to Dallas, y'all. And, you know, we ready to turn up.
You ready to turn up?
I am. I don't know about you.
You ready?
I am.
You came with the alcohol?
But did you come, like, do you got a whole, like, itinerary and stuff like
that?
Why
I gotta come up with the itinerary?
Because I'm a guest this time. I'm not, like,
but you've been here. You done lived here before.
That's not the point. I'm a guest this time.
So you know where you want to go, right?
No.
That is crazy. See, y'all can't leave stuff in black people's hands, obviously.
I need to know where the party's at. I want to go to the parade to see all the Halloween costumes.
Yeah, y'all gotta let us know what's the hottest spots in Dallas to go to. Mm. I don't really get out, so I wouldn't know.
Okay. There we go, lying already.
I get out.
We just got back. You already lying again.
That's crazy.
I feel like you always out.
Forget all that, cause you talking nonsense. How was your week?
My week has been good. I've been working. I got a little raise at work. You know what I'm saying?
Did you?
So I'll step forward, y'all. But I got a little raise. Yeah, it's been a good week. Yeah.
I would've been hectic. Mm. You know, I just helped my mama move. Y'all, your girl is strong. I carried a couch up 3 flights of stairs with my brother by ourselves. So, you know, I'm out here benching 250, probably 300. That's what's funny.
And I benching 250.
Benching 250.
Okay, we got a new PR.
Yeah.
Okay. So, you in the gym?
I'm a gym girl, I guess not.
Yeah.
You know?
If you bench at 250, you a gym girl.
I mean, what is the...
you a powerlifter?
Yes. I'm glad you knew exactly what I was going to say. Yes,
you're not no damn powerlifter.
All right, now.
Okay.
So, what's the topic today?
So, even though I said this has been a good week, it really ain't been a good week, y'all. I did. I definitely just lie again. I know. Damn.
You love to lie.
I know.
I don't even think we can trust you no more.
Yeah.
At this point,
just don't. At this point,
what you lie about?
So, you know, my dad was in the hospital this week, and you know, stuff like that is just very traumatic for me and stuff like that. And it just really started making me think about just parenting in general,
right?
And just like parents really be just humans having another human, and you forced to raise this little motherfucker, and you don't know what to do,
right?
And motherfucker, y'all act like y'all know what to do. Y'all don't be knowing what y'all be doing.
I don't think nobody ever.
I'm gonna put you in there.
Say I'm a good parent or I'm great at it. I was gonna say I don't think nobody is really ready to be a parent. Like that's just something that comes along as you are a parent. Like, okay, well, I'm getting the hang of this. This is what type of parenting style I want to do, or this is how I want to raise my child. I don't think somebody come out like, yeah, this, and this. But you know how like in the beginning I was like, I ain't gonna never whoop my kid, or I ain't gonna never yell at my child.
And what you don't, and you need to.
I have lately.
Girl,
what are you saying?
Barely yelling. You need
things
to taste
does
that little.
Change. What?
Cardi is out of hand.
Cardi is not out of hand.
Cardi
He's
is
been
unhinged.
In check lately.
No.
Yes.
He's not in check at all.
That is. I don't need you telling my business because
okay,
I just said my baby in check.
He in check, y'all.
Thank you.
He really in check.
Thank you. Real in check.
It surprised me. I know. I said, oh, is he in boarding school? He in check. I feel like sometimes people just have kids and they just want babies. Like, they don't really mm-hmm. want to be a parent. And then when that kid get older and got to go to school, y'all don't be wanting to take them to school. Y'all don't be helping with their homework. Y'all want to cuss their teachers out because y'all kids a little behind. And y'all not trying to help. And then when that boy came out on TikTok and made that video and went viral talking about them kids, them seventh graders who all on like third grade reading level, mm-hmm. and the parents like, oh, COVID. COVID was 2 years ago. Your kids is all the way back in second grade still. Like, wow. that's been going on. And y'all still not doing nothing about it because all this No Child Left Behind and stuff. I feel like that should have never been in place because that ain't doing nothing but fucking these kids up.
How would you say you feel your parents were raising you?
Very strict, overly strict. I feel like it was hard to have like hopes and dreams of stuff because everything was super like survival mode. Like, you know, they depended on welfare and all that stuff. Like, it wasn't no, oh, when I grow up, I'm gonna be an actor. I'm gonna da da da. You mm-hmm. know, like, I played piano, but it wasn't no real like I'm finna go
be an artist. Keys,
you know what I'm saying?
Right.
Yeah. So it's just like, I feel like that to me made it a little rougher when I got older. Like, some stuff just felt so out of reach, but it's like people don't know, like, if you really want something, you put your mind to something, like everything is possible.
Do you feel like you also can, during that time, because you said they were strict, do you feel like you were able to at least go to them and speak to them on like different stuff?
Hell fucking no.
Your face said it all by the time you been finishing it.
See, the difference though, parents and especially moms that I've seen, watching or witnessing a mom who hates her kids or especially hates her daughters,
right?
That I feel like I never felt that. Like, my mom, I feel like I couldn't go to her and necessarily talk to her about stuff just because I was afraid. But I feel like I could trust her though.
See, and that's where I feel like it was opposite for me. I felt like my mama hated me. Mm-hmm. Like, I feel like my mom did not want me.
Yeah.
And that wasn't all the time. It's just like, I don't know how to explain it, but it's like certain moments, like, she just go off the deep end for the simplest thing. It's weird, but like, I literally, she choked me up because I lost a hairbrush. So it's just like little stuff like that, or just cussing me out. But growing up, I can definitely give it to her. She used to be big on like, I don't call my daughters bees and da da da. But that has changed. Like, now she'd be quick to call me out my name. And it's like, as a mother that has a daughter, you'll feel like, you know, that's something you teach them not to do.
Not
like,
to be, yeah.
Like, you degrading another woman. Mm-hmm. And it ain't like I'm a little girl now. I'm a grown woman. So it's like, I don't feel like even as a grown woman now, I can go to my mom and be like, hey, I didn't like this that you said. I don't like this without it being like, oh, you being disrespectful or you talking out of turn type of thing.
Yeah.
So I don't know. It's two different things. And I feel like sometimes that kind of leads to, like, cutting people off, like, your family, because your peace come into place, or just, like, your mental, like, okay, when is enough is enough? Like, you teach me not to accept disrespect from other people, but I'm receiving it at home.
Exactly. Yeah. I feel like that definitely started, too, as the kids. Like, you don't want your kids saying nothing back to you or questioning nothing, but it's like, think about you as an adult. If somebody just told you, get your ass up and go paint the house.
Right.
You're like, why the fuck I gotta get up and paint the house? But let your kid be wondering. It's like, it's okay for them to quit. It's like, why? You know what I'm saying? I don't feel like that's always disrespectful.
That's crazy that you bring that up, because we talk about my son too, and you see how like the parenting style is kind of different because of that. Even like, he asked me a question, and if he asks it in front of her, she feels some type of way, like, why is he talking to you like that? Why is this? Right. That's not your little friend. And it's like, it's not my little friend, but I also want that door open where my child can ask me, or if he don't understand, or if he wants to learn, that I'm able to talk to him about that. It's a difference between being somebody, being his little friend, and also being informative to my child and leading him the proper way that I can.
Because then how would you feel if, as your son got older and he started confiding in his friends, mom and stuff like that, and it's like, I'm right here, and you don't even feel comfortable enough to talk to me.
It's some people that's really like that. It's great that you brought that point up, seriously, because who was we talking about? It was somebody that said that exact same thing before. Oh, I can't even put that out there. I'm not going to name drop because, yeah. But they basically was saying that because their child comes to my mom, which is crazy because I can't come to my mom. And she confides in my mom about different stuff that goes on. But then her mom had asked my mom, like, what is it that you do for your kids to always want to be around you? Like, even mama going crazy, I still, like, you know what I mean? Like, how she be, like, going off the walls. I still respect her as my mom because that's, like, you only get one parent. Yeah. So, it's just, like, of course I'm going to want to spend time with you. Of course I want that relationship with you. But sometimes it just... It's it hard. It becomes too much and it's just like it's draining. But it's like, it's hard. I don't even know how to explain it. To cut a parent off and never talk to a parent again, knowing that they're alive. Right. It's like, it's people out here that don't have their parents. So it's just like you crave and want that relationship, but at the same time, you want that peace and you want that respect or that mental peace.
Because then when you get to that point of like separating, like, this is my mom, but when you become an adult and you separate that, like, this another human, and I really don't fuck with you just as a human. Like, you're just really not a good person in general. Like, you know what I mean? Like, I don't know. I feel like I never had to, you know, my mom unfortunately passed away when I was 20, but even with my dad, I feel like I'm there for him, and I support him. I help him while he's going through what he's going through, but I feel like I almost was at that phase with him where it's kind of like, I just kind of don't like you as a person.
Right.
And sometimes I hate to say that because I know what he's going through, you know what I'm saying? And I feel like people make me feel guilty to be like, well, you know, he gonna be gone one day and but it's like, while we both on this earth, I shouldn't have to fake and pretend. Right. You know what I'm saying? Like, I still respect you, I still come over here and help you, I do everything you ask me to do, but it's like, this is just kind of what the relationship is. If I can't force you to want to fix it. And I'm not gonna sit here and constantly bicker and bring it up. Like, it's just gonna be is what it is.
I agree. But you know what else is that kind of leads into too, that makes me think about that, is like how our parents raised us and how they treat our kids now. Because completely different. Like, mama say little stuff or whatever, but she gives my son the world, and that's what's crazy. It's like, when I was a kid, you was acting like you hated me. Like, but then it's like with my son, it's like, oh, will Cardi want this? Will Cardi this? And you know, like, all
this. I know, grandparents be different.
But to the extent, because then sometimes she'd be like, real mean. And I'd be like, okay, now you're doing too much. No, seriously. Mama, I think my baby was like either 2 or 3, and she like snatched him up. I'm like, okay, well, now.
Yeah.
You know, he's still a kid. You don't got to do all that.
Do you know who Raymonte is on TikTok?
Who's that?
He a content creator, whatever. But he made a post talking about these new age grandparents that don't want to be called grandma. And he was like, what the fuck is all this yaya and all that? Like, you are your grandma.
Or Gigi. Exactly. Or grandma. Yeah.
Pam, you're grandma. Grandmother is what you are.
Like, they don't want to be grandparents, honestly. Because the grandparents ain't the same as when we was growing up, because I was at grandma's house all the time. I was at y'all's house, you know?
I was going to say, not us.
Y'all didn't go to y'all grandparents?
No.
She said no.
No.
Definitely not. I already know.
Exactly. No. So I don't even know what that, like, I'm trying to do that. Like, no, I have no idea nothing about that.
No, like, I see a lot of the younger women, which is true, where they, you know, your mom or your dad ain't the one that laid down with your partner to have your child, but it's just like y'all don't have that type of grandparents love or touch anymore. It's like, okay. Even, I feel like that turned into, like, with the holidays, too. It's just, like, you know, everybody used to come to grandma's house and be at the holidays.
Yeah.
No.
How do you feel about, okay, I know it's kind of, maybe it's kind of harsh and bad to say, a little maybe controversial, whatever. But I feel like there's definitely bad parents in this world. I feel like.
What do you mean by bad parents?
Just, and even just the physical look of your kid. You're put together, ready to go to the club, and your kid
is running around.
You know what I'm saying? Shoes too little, or you know what I'm saying? And it's
like
different.
Their priorities are messed up.
It's different when you can't, and you can't afford something or something like that. Right. But it's like you just
out here
giving
in
you
Gucci
don't care,
and your child is just like not old clothes, can't fit your clothes, diaper hanging,
all of that. Yeah, and even when I was talking about kids being behind, it's like it just be giving y'all don't care. And then it's y'all not even gonna go get help for them or nothing like that. Like, your kid can't read, don't know their letters, nothing. Like,
and you know what's so crazy in our generation that you bring that up? A lot of them, a lot of women be trying to say it's men, but you see a lot of women being deadbeat moms too, mm-hmm. just as well.
My mom friend's daughter was on child support. That was the first time I ever heard that. Like, when I was younger, I don't know why.
Her mom was on child support?
No, my mom's friend's daughter, which was a grown lady.
Oh.
Her daughter is an adult who has a kid.
Okay, say it again. I'm listening.
My mom's friend, yeah. her daughter, who is a grown woman, yeah. has a kid, and she was on child support. But I don't know why.
I don't know why I'm not clicking and getting it.
Do you get it? Okay. That's just like, you're Pam's daughter and you're on child support.
Why am I on child support?
Because she's not the same way you put a nigga on child support. He put her on child support.
Okay, hold on. No, I really got to think about this. Because what I thought you were saying was that the kid got to pay the child support. That's what
I'm asking you. Hang this shit up. Why would the kid be paying child support?
You said the kid was on child support. So, okay.
I literally said my mom's friend's daughter
was on child support.
Ain't you somebody's daughter?
It don't matter. The way you said it.
He got it.
So you could have said her mama was on child support.
Right. I did.
I did too. And you was like, no, the daughter.
I really be fed up. Oh my God.
So that was your first time seeing a woman on child support.
Yes.
That's what I just asked you.
Is that not crazy though?
It is.
I mean, it's not, but it's like, I just never heard that.
Yeah.
I usually hear women who just like, child support card. You know what I mean?
Now that man is in child support card.
I was just like, wow, like you'll take care of your daughter.
But
like,
did you ever see her around her daughter or with her?
Not when we first met them. And then eventually she had visitation and shit. Like, even that was different. I'm like, visitation? I mean, I know that's kind of a common thing.
Do you feel like she wanted to be a mom? Like your vibe from her, like the vibe
no,
you got from her?
No. It just seemed like she had kids and was the, you know, parents who be like, you know, mama got to have a life too.
Mm-hmm.
Which I get, but it's like, you know, I don't know. It ain't my kid. I don't know.
Look. What you know? Look.
No, I don't know nothing about it.
I ain't got no kids.
See, I know. And I feel like I'm afraid to have kids just because it's like, this really is a human being that like depend on me. Mm-hmm. Like,
do you feel like a lot of people pressure you? Know how people like, when you gonna have a baby? When you...
Only Miss Marquita Garrett.
Not named.
That's the only one. Nobody else.
How do you feel about that, though?
I feel like she's saying it in a joking way, but nobody has really ever been like, oh, you should have a kid.
Because
then if you say that, my next question is always going to be why. Because what I'm going to do, what do you expect me to do?
Yeah.
Like, are you think I'm going to be this just amazing mother who is just, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. I feel like I'm just not even there yet.
See, that just opened a whole box that I kind of want to talk about, but it's a lot. But it's just like, you know, people ask that question to people and never know mentally where they stand or financially where they stand. It's like, back home, you see a lot of the women are now committing suicide. Mm-hmm. I don't know if that's like the same around the world, but I know back home that's a lot. And they are taking their kids with them. Mm-hmm. Like, well, if I don't have help here on earth, why would I leave my child behind type of thing, which is really crazy and wild to me because it's just like, I think we should stop asking that question to people and trying to force that parenting on them because you never know if they are ready to be a parent. Okay. Everybody not like, okay, well, you know, let's try this parenting thing out.
That should go way past little cute pictures and little cute outfits and shoes and shit. That motherfucker got to go to the dentist. They got to go to the doctor.
School.
They're going to grow up, start cussing. Okay. They're going to be talking bad.
They got to do with anything.
I'm just saying, like, you really, like, look at all the phases you went through in your life and you got to deal with that with somebody else.
Yeah.
And while also teaching them how to be a
person.
Yeah,
and
like,
living in this life.
Yeah. So, count me the fuck out as of right now.
Count you out.
Count me out, please. Please.
I love
you. You know, I'll Auntie of the Year. Cardi loves
you. You doing good.
And, you know, that's all. You know, I just call, FaceTime, hey, how you doing? Play a little Roblox, buy a little Robux. You know what I'm saying? I'm really the rich auntie. I can spend a little $10. But what?
I'm going to do you like he did. She did him on the icon with love.
He said, what I'm going to do with two more kids? What's love got to do with
yeah,
it?
Yeah, what love's got to do with
no.
it?
No.
Bye. Drop him off right at your doorstep.
And guess who I'm calling?
The police. Yeah. You want me to go to jail so bad. That is
you
crazy.
You want you to go to jail. You don't leave your kids nowhere.
That's your nephew, though.
Don't. Tashina, that's your don't nephew, leave, though. Don't leave your kids nowhere you ain't at.
You there.
You ain't there.
In spirit, I am, you know? Yeah. So, definitely don't.
It's not really giving the same, you know what I mean?
I guess.
But anyway, y'all, be better parents.
Not be better parents.
That's all I got. Just try a little harder, and if you can't and you need some help, ask for help. Like, these little kids be dependent on y'all, like, you know what I mean?
They definitely do.
That's all I got. You're a mom. Give them a little advice from a mother.
I don't think they want my advice. I'm a gentle parent.
Yeah, and the worst gentle parent is like.
I don't know. Just take it one day at a time. Look, be patient. It's okay to go in the bathroom and run away from your child. Don't let nobody make you feel guilty. They'll be okay.
Do you remember that post about that lady who? She put her baby down to go to sleep, and then she went to go to sleep, and when it woke up, the dad brought it to her.
Brought the baby?
Instead of just letting her sleep and, like, him dealing with it, he woke her up and brought her the baby again.
That's so disrespectful.
It's like...
That's so disrespectful.
I can't do shit.
Yeah, that's why I say be careful. And I'm gonna say be careful when you have kids.
No, seriously, that too.
I had a story, but I can't seem to pull it up. But basically, it was a guy asking for advice about the same thing, we kind of touched on, that his parents doesn't like that he's smart, so, like, they think he's a smart ass and literally, you know, try to degrade him every chance they get. Mm. And he doesn't know how he should handle that situation with his parents.
He's still young, or...
He's 18.
Honestly, you just gonna have to really focus on yourself and getting yourself out of their house. Unfortunately, I believe that it's just a certain amount of, like, I don't even want to say respect, but it's just a certain amount of, like, I guess respect that you have to have living in somebody else's house. Mm-hmm. And I say you got to deal with it until you get out of there, but... Somewhat, you know what I'm saying? And until you can be on your own, functioning by yourself, I feel like that's really your only option. Unless you're going to go live with somebody else, and that's always a little tough sometimes.
Yeah, definitely so.
Well, and also, I know we're about to wrap it up. I'm sorry.
You're 18. I want to know if he was going to college, because you can go stay on dorms. You don't really got too much to do with that. Go stay, find somewhere to, you know, crash.
Yeah. My little just... In little piece, and we can talk about this in another episode, because I know we finna wrap it up. But parents, back to when I was saying that some of y'all be bad parents. Some of y'all do be bad parents, and y'all need to listen to y'all kids when they tell y'all that somebody is bothering them or somebody's touching them inappropriately, and stop just letting them play by themselves and not going to check on them kids, because kids be doing weird shit too.
Yeah.
But yeah, that'll be for, we'll say that for another time. Cause I got a lot to say about that shit, because that shit is so bogus to me.
No, we're gonna say that for another time.
But yeah, anyway. Y'all know at the end of every episode we always play I Know You Fucking Lying. So are you ready today? We should have had him get the shots, because I feel like you're gonna lose today.
That is wild. What you got up your sleeve?
How many?
You did some thinking?
Maybe. I got one for today. I keep it light on you. I'll give you one today.
Okay.
How many hotels can you name?
I can name five.
Whore.
Wow.
I didn't get that. Why did you start so high?
I can name five. That escalated real quickly. What you mean by that?
You being a whore?
What they got to do with a hotel?
What you think you got to do with a hotel?
Please explain.
Why you be in so many hotel rooms?
Who said I've been in the hotel rooms?
Oh, who be in them?
Who said I ain't a low key pimp? Yeah, all right. Thank you.
I got six.
You're fucking lying.
La cuenta. Hilton.
Ooh.
Marriott.
Ding, ding, ding.
Fuck. Crown Plaza.
And your time is up, Miss Ma'am.
Was that only four?
Yes.
Dang.
Yeah, you should have brought the shots.
Hello. Anyways, we don't got the shots.
You was funny. So my, I know you fucking lying, is how many baby, oh, how can I put it, necessary baby items do you need?
Just in general or at the hospital?
Or that you see on registries.
Oh, I can name you can put it on that. 9.
Really? Mm-hmm. I could probably name 11.
I can name 12.
I know you.
Okay, pacifier, bottle, breastfeeding pump, pajamas, socks, hat, blanket, snot remover.
You ugly. Thinking of all things.
Car seat. Hand mittens.
You're 30 seconds up, dope.
Cradle cap scraper.
I give it to you.
I know it's right. Okay. I can be a mama.
You ready? Look. At this point, I guess she's ready.
Seems
for motherhood.
Like I'm ready.
Okay.
Okay.
Look, not okay. Okay, before we wrap it up, you already know I do the word of the day. And I ain't gonna lie.
Try to pronounce it first. Let me see. Eldritch.
That do sound like Eldritch.
Okay.
I was gonna say Eldritch, but.
Oh, shit.
Let's see. Oh, I had my phone turned down.
Eldritch.
Eldritch.
I'm so fucking smart. I should be a teacher.
And Eldritch describes the things that are strange or unnatural, especially in a way that inspires fear. The word is often used as a synonym. So a sentence would be like, she's afraid to visit haunted houses because the Eldritch decor and sound effects are too realistic for her liking.
Mm. Okay, Miss Aquila and the Bee.
Marlena is very Eldritch. You are very strange sometimes.
Y'all,
I'm learning new stuff every day,
you're
y'all,
not learning
at this
nothing.
Point.
Y'all, leave in the comments.
You can
let
call
us
me
know.
Akilah.
And I will. Let us know what y'all think of the new setup. You know what I'm saying? This might be the new spot for a little while.
This might be our new home.
Yeah. So let us know what y'all think of the new setup. Make sure y'all following us on Facebook, TikTok, Instagram,
YouTube.
YouTube, all that at Too Familiar. And we'll be back next week.
Yep. Bye. Nobody.